Councillors, any objection to the phone or no? Okay.
You could say.
Don't have any interest?
No.
No. No.
Not interested.
A lot of people missing tonight. We've got Denise, Roberts, Michelle and Councillor Chris Jones is deputising and we have John Hayes who's also. And just for Bruce, Amber Davis, Chair of Standards, I call down the table because being the man I'm also going to.
John Hayes.
Anyway.
Part of that, Councillor.
Stop texting, Councillor.
It's just Councillor C.
You already know it. Fix it up already. Another independent person.
That means that's awesome.
Just about. Chair.
Shirt.
Okay then, any massive rise on the reds in the last week?
No, please.
Any observation? No. You read that?
Yes, I agree.
Thank you. Item three. Some complaints. Take us through these.
Yes, Deputy Chair, this is just the annual report in relation to the history of complaints made in the movements of the Congress that we dealt with since the 1st of April of last year through to effectively the 5th of June this year. Summarise the position with regards to the prevalent complaint at the table to 2.4. Apologies for the typographical error on the period of the first box that was the 1st of April 13. Total complaints received last year was 6, 2 from members and 4 from the public. 2 were matters that following a preliminary evaluation and assessment undertaken by myself, following a consultation with the at least one independent person and 3 group leaders, taking all those factors into account before referring to the investigation. And we'll see that none of those complaints were upheld last year. To date, however, we have received the same number of complaints in the first quarter, essentially. Again, the ratio is the same in terms of the member complaints and public complaints. There is one that has been will be referred to investigation very shortly. So that's the summary in terms of the number of cases. You'll see Appendix 1 in a little bit more detail in relation to those cases that I've set out in terms of what we received, the outcome in essence, and also the nature of the complaint. This is an opportunity for you to consider that detail, and particularly look at any particular themes or particular issues that you feel need to be considered a bit more in mind, and take a view as to whether any further action is required in terms of raising awareness on the broader standards committee, particularly looking at any particular areas that you need to focus on. Have to take questions shared on those matters. I can't obviously disclose information specifically around each case for confidentiality reasons, but hope this issue is not going to
be too.
Thanks, Chair. So just as I'm asking the name, but just asking for clarification. Before people in 2014, are any of those the same or are they important?
Public.
They are different.
Don't think there's anyone. As you know, one of the key things that we wanted to address was ensuring that investigations and matters were dealt with properly. Where matters were referred for investigation, in this case, there was an issue of availability and ensuring some of the information that we needed to obtain was provided as quickly as possible for that investigation to be obtained. And the investigator did have some difficulties in terms of getting the level of cooperation. Some of it was maybe cooperation, some of it was obtaining availability. One of the difficulties we do with the local issue is members available to come and find people. And that's not a reflection on the process, the investigator, or the legal members who are involved, or anyone else for that matter. Sometimes time you can work against the investigation being completely quickly. And so, I don't think there were some issues that I think arose. I did try to engage with the individual concern and to ensure that we could find ourselves in some difficulty next time, but it's probably a more difficult case than we have to do that. We have to move that now, going into detail. So the work program of the work committee was quite comprehensive in terms of the work that we did. One of the not all the work was completed as anticipated, but what it did do is identify some other areas that the work group had been using felt needed to be dealt with in this year. And I've set those out on page 16 and the following in total. standard is not just about dealing with complaints and ensuring the arrangements are in place. There's actually a statutory duty of the notice amount on councils. There's a duty to promote high standards of conduct amongst members. And so there was the other side of the point, which often sometimes doesn't get as much exposure or indeed review. And one of the things that the work programme and the work committee wanted to do was to start looking at how we actually do promote higher and better standards of the conduct and not just dealing with complaints when they're in. And one of the areas that was focused on was developing a protocol of etiquette so that everyone is clear around standard of conduct and behaviour. And going back in some cases, so the lost etiquette that was once around that we're looking at re-establishing that maybe in the modern 21st century, but looking at how we re-establish that, particularly in council chamber and so on and so forth. And so the work around the protocol ties in with the overarching corporate drive to actually improve behaviour and culture within the organisation. And that's why I'm suggesting that as part of the work around the initiative, that protocol approach is developed in line with the council's professional development team, who are pushing the corporate picture around corporate behaviour and culture. So that's the first line of work. The second one is about the members ICT policy, and quickly the nature of work that has been troubling on ICT. The ICT policy probably hasn't been reviewed for a little while, and it's linked directly to the standards side of things, because clearly the use of resources you need to be around the full way and how it's on board. And then maybe to identify some areas that probably require a little bit more clarity, and these would probably improve so that members have greater flexibility with regards to some of the resources that are available to them, and importantly know to what extent they can use the resources that are provided. So I'm suggesting that policy is considered by this committee.
Can I suggest that beyond
I'm suggesting that part of the review, which is different from last year, also includes information governance. And one of the things that we're probably focusing on in the new group, along with all of the improvements we make around governance, is ensuring that information governance and all the issues and responsibilities are understood. And as members, you clearly handle a lot of information, personal and sensitive information, depending on your roles, and you handle your constituency information, personal data there that you regularly handle. It's important that you also understand your responsibilities in that regard, and we support you in ensuring that you do have the appropriate support available to you to ensure that you don't fall foul of any information governance requirements. So it's one area that I think is linking with the council's information governance board, which is not select board, to actually some of the corporate improvements that we need to make about information governance, which is healthy and to practice, and clearly there needs to be a member on, a member to that board to make sure that the member involved in the game is there on that particular area. The earlier point I made around the side of that point is to look at promoting high standards, not just dealing with complaints from the economy. And that's a piece of work that can be encouraged and trained members in that particular exercise. And last but not least, as you would expect, that's the substantive to your remit is again monitoring and keeping the constitution under review done by the representative in terms of the approval out during the course of the year to ensure that any changes that are required are agreed to maintain. One example is the issue of building the regulations around building the volume of tweeting and then come up to order by the end of this month. So from that perspective, there's a number of areas that we need to ensure that the constitution reflects some of those changes. So those are the key areas that I've suggested to you. Obviously, if you can look at any further areas of work you feel are necessary in terms of your previous
work. I just have a comment. Over the years, I've noticed that there's been less and less public coming to see our councils and so on. I think this has a bearing on as well, because
faculty at any of them decent.
I think we'd have to sort of idea. I mean, we could go to colleges and scholars and I'm sort of seeing colleges go and say art galleries and some I seem to know of the stations that they would be part of.
Yeah, I think you're sure to add a fifth, sixth item to the work program to include the work group will work on to consider how the economy it's a very similar setup as it was previously in terms of agreement and happy to be able to then turn to represent my government to improve the initial two points I mentioned in terms of the work. The membership of the committee will effectively consist of yourself as chair, two further Labour group members, two Conservative group members, and one Liberal Democrat group member, and the chair will cast some votes. The parties, sorry, the members will have the opportunity to nominate deputies to attend, provided they are members of this committee. The meeting will be called as we're required and we call it to the membership in attendance. The meeting will be private and they're not subject to the access to information rules. And the working group will be a decision making body to make recommendations to the chairman to have consideration and approval required.
All the councils to attend that.
Yes, I mean, the more the merrier.
And independence.